Okay, y'all, so the reason finger detangling does not work is because finger detangling only gets out the tangles that your fingers get out. Meaning, when your hair is wet, or just say water touches the hair is gonna shrink and coil around each other. So when the hair coils around each other, the hair is now tangled. Let's just say it's tangled. So when you come and try to finger detangle and, you know, get out this tangle, get out that tangle, you're leaving a lot more tangles in that section of hair. You're only getting out the tangles that your finger gets out, but there's a lot more. And so when you come on the next wash day, or you try to style or manipulate your hair, you rub it or, you know, touch it, and then you see a lot of hair in the comb or in your hand, it's because you never got out the tangles that was caused from wetting your hair. Okay, y'all, so I forgot to mention in the previous clip, if you're going to finger detangle your hair, I think you should always follow with a comb that has a lot of teeth. Not a wide tooth comb, because there's not a lot of teeth. And it's pretty much like finger detangling. You're not getting out a lot of tangles with the wide tooth comb. So always follow with like the medium sized comb that I show in my videos. Always follow with a comb that has at least that many teeth to ensure that you're getting out as many tangles as possible. Okay, so some of the common issues that my clients who only finger detangle experience. Okay, so I'm just gonna go down the list right now, and then I'll come back and kind of give an explanation as to why I think they've experienced these issues. They experience long pieces of hair, tangles, the hair only grows to shoulder length. They experience shedding, edges, and hairline issues, dry hair. Okay, and the data also shows that the clients who only finger detangle, they wash their hair only once a month or longer, and they use grease. Okay, so as far as the long pieces of hair, you know, when you finger detangle, you start at the top and you separate the hair like that. So I'm thinking with the tangles that were mentioned, the tangles may cause the hair strands to pop from the roots. And so that's where the long strands of hairs are coming from. Regarding the shoulder length hair, I'm thinking that, you know, when you're losing these strands of hair, you're also losing length. It depends on where the long strands of hair that you're losing are located on your head. Meaning, if you lose hair from up here, like just say right up in here, you may lose a strand. It's not so much going to affect the length of your hair down here. But if you lose hair down here, because it makes your hair appears longer, you'll see a big difference in the length of your hair, because up here, you still got hair down here. But if you're losing hair right here, you really don't have any hair down here. You get what I'm saying? I hope that makes sense. Regarding shedding, as I have mentioned in previous videos, a lot of the hair that we're losing is not shedded hair, it's breakage. So the hair does shed, but not as much as, you know, you may think. The big balls of hair, to me, that's just a lot of breakage, and it's due to the roots of the hair up here not being cleansed thoroughly. The sebum buildup is there, and when water touches it, it congeals. And I'll leave a link right here that includes more details about, you know, my opinion of what happens when the sebum builds up at the roots. Regarding the dry hair, keep in mind, the hair dries out in 2 to 3 days. The hair and the scalp dries out in 2 to 3 days. So I did mention that the clients only wash their hair once a month. So if the hair and scalp dries out in 2 to 3 days and you've gone an entire month without washing your hair, just imagine how dry the hair is. As well as, you gotta be mindful of your wash day routine. How are you protecting your hair from the shampoo? Because we all know that the shampoo, whether it's sulfate free or whatever, is designed to strip the hair and cleanse the hair. So if you're not protecting your hair from the shampoo, you may experience dry hair. So now the issue with the edges and the hairline, now that kind of caught me off guard because I was kind of thinking like, well, what does that have to do with finger detangling? So I had to dig a little bit deeper to find additional common factors. So one thing I found is that the client's go-to hairstyle was either twist or braids. So I was thinking, well, maybe if they're not using a comb to detangle the edges also coil up. You know, when water or some kind of wet product touches it, they coil up. So if you don't thoroughly detangle your edges and you leave them in that tangled state for just say a month, you know, you haven't washed it in a month. So if you leave your hair, the edges in that tangled state for a month, I can see the hair breaking off because number one, it's dry. And then you have the hair, the edges pulled up in a twist, which is putting tension on that area. And again, it's dry. So when you go to sleep, or even if you tie the hair down, the friction of that scarf or the friction from the pillowcase can cause the hair to break in that area. You know, the perimeter, the edges, the hairline. So I decided to dig a little bit deeper. I was just curious to know, is there like a common product that the clients are using on their edges? My thought was maybe gel to gel the edges up or lay the baby hairs down. So I looked at the data to see what was the common hair care product that they were using. So believe it or not, I found the clients were using Shea Moisture shampoo and conditioner. It was the common product line that the clients were using. And so I was like, no, this can't be true. Because if you've been following my channel, I posted several videos to show y'all that I used the Shea Moisture on my daughter Nadia's edges, thinking it would be so gentle. And the edges just completely fell out. That could be the reason the edges fell into the category of, you know, a common issue. I don't know. Okay, y'all, that's pretty much it for this video. If you're interested in a hair care consultation, I've left additional details down in the description box, so be sure to check out the description box. Be sure to thumbs up this video. Be sure to share this video with all of your social media friends. And as always, leave me some comments. And guys, until the next video, bye-bye.